Hello all, welcome to today's Electronic Circuit Analysis and Design online lecture. Today we are going to discuss BJT Differential Amplifier Numericals. So let us start with BJT Differential Amplifier. This is my circuit configuration of a dual input. It has two inputs, V1 and V2. So it is a dual input balance output, since there are two outputs over here, and it is called as a dual input balance output differential amplifier. So it's a symmetric network. That means my transistor beta 1 and beta 2 are same, VB1 and VB2 are same, RB1 and RB2 external resistors also might be same, and RC1 and RC2 external collector resistors are also same. So it requires two power supplies, one positive and one negative, that is VCC and minus VEE. So let us go to the different types of configuration. So these are my different configurations for differential amplifier. The first one over here we have seen before. This is a DIBO. The second one over here doesn't have one input, so it is a single input balance output differential amplifier. So your left hand side, you have your dual input unbalanced output differential amplifier, because the output is taken from only from one side of the collector terminal, other side is not connected. So this output is taken with respect to collector and ground. Similarly, you have on the right hand side single input unbalanced output differential amplifier. So these are my four configurations of a BJT differential amplifier. Now we will see the summary of BJT differential amplifier, all the formulas which we are going to be using. So first of all, we'll see DC analysis. So the good news is DC analysis, the formula remains the same for all the configurations, that is for DIBO, DIUO, SIBO and SIUO. So it remains absolutely same. Now we'll see what is the formula for ICQ. So ICQ will be beta times VEE minus VBE upon RB plus 2 times 1 plus beta times RE. So this is the formula for ICQ. Note here, RB can be written as RS or RSIG. As per given in the numerical, you have to substitute these values, but the concept will remain the same. And the VCEQ, after analyzing, we will get VCC plus VE minus ICQ into RC plus twice RE. So this is the formula for ICQ and VCEQ. Note that in a differential amplifier, since it is a symmetric network, whatever value of ICQ is, that will be equal to IC1 and IC2 if all the external and the internal parameters are same. Similarly, VCEQ1 will be equal to VCEQ2 if all the external and the internal parameters in a DFAM are same. So that you have to take care. Also, the VE supply over here, it is already taken into consideration as a negative sign. So here you substitute the value of VE as positive. Here also you have to substitute the magnitude of VE only. If we add swamping resistors, there is a concept of swamping resistors, which will be, let me just show you the circuit diagram of a swamping resistor. Yeah, so if you have a swamping resistor, that is RE1, here it is RE dash and RE dash. So the formula changes as follows. We'll go back to the circuitry. So with swamping resistors, that is RE swamp or some other terminology may also be used, there is an addition of RE swamp term over here in ICQ formula. Rest formula remains the same. Similarly, there is an addition of RE swamp term in VCEQ equation. So if in the numerical these RE swamp swamping resistors are given, you have to accommodate like this in ICQ and VCEQ formula. Now we'll come back to the AC analysis. After getting the value of the Q point, that is ICQ and VCEQ, you need to calculate the differential voltage gain AD and the common mode voltage gain ACM. So before that, we have to calculate the value of small signal parameter RPi, which is given by beta VT upon ICQ, where beta might be given in the circuitry and VT is around 26 millivolt. ICQ, whatever ICQ value you get from here or you get from here, you have to substitute it here and you have to substitute the value of ICQ here and calculate RPi. Similarly, since the differential amplifier network is symmetric, RPi 1 will be equal to RPi 2 will be equal to this formula. Now we'll go for the AC analysis. In AC analysis, we are calculating the differential mode gain and the common mode gain. So for DIBO, the formula of AD is beta times RC upon RB plus RPi. Again, the value of the terminology of RB can be different. It can be RB or RS for RSIG for a BJT differential amplifier only, this terminology. And similarly, if we add a swamping resistor, so the formula will become as beta RC upon RB plus RPi plus beta times R swamp. Here it is R swamp. So this term is added in the differential gain formula. So basically, your differential gain will reduce further by adding this swamping resistor. Well, another good news is the common mode gain formula, that is ACM, that is equal to modular of mod of RC upon twice RE. Formula will remain same for all the configurations. Now we'll move on to DIUO. Basically, the difference between DIBO and DIUO is in the formula is AD is almost half of whatever we have found out in DIBO. Similarly, AD with RE swamp resistor is also half of whatever we found in the DIBO formula, and ACM remains the same. So the basic difference between DIBO and DIUO is in DIUO, the differential voltage gain reduces to half the value of DIBO. Now we move on to SIBO. Well, SIBO, that is single input balance output, the formula is same as DIBO. So AD is given by beta RC upon RPi plus RB, and ACM is given as RC upon twice RE. And the formula is for SIUO, that is same as DIUO. So AD will be half of whatever you got in DIUO. So these are the formulas. Now, after calculating the differential voltage gain and the common mode voltage gain, we calculate an important parameter of DFAM, that is called as CMRR. Now, CMRR is basically AD upon ACM. And if we want to calculate in dB, its formula is CMRR in dB is 20 log of log to the base 10, that is AD upon ACM. So always have a good practice of calculating the CMRR values as follows. Now let us go back to one of the numericals. So if this is the numerical given to you, let me do one thing. Okay, so I have adjusted the two PDFs together so that in one PDF I will continuously show the circuit diagram which we want to calculate the Q point and other parameters. And other right hand side, I will show you the solution how to solve this. So this is my differential amplifier. This is actually my DIUO amplifier. So accordingly, we will solve now. So the DC analysis will remain the same. So as you can see, this DC analysis can be reduced to this simple network over here. So applying the formulas, you get the value of IBQ first. See to it that you get the value of IBQ up till 4 decimals. Not only IBQ, all other parameters which you want to find, either a current or a voltage or a voltage gain, that is AD, ACM or CMRR, always find up till 4 digits. It's always good. So IBQ is this value. ICQ will be beta times IBQ. And since the network is symmetric, my ICQ1 will be equal to ICQ2 will be equal to ICQ. So always keep a habit of writing this together. So let me just expand it a little now. Yeah, you can see the screen now. Now next is we find VCQ. So as I have said you earlier, VEE value has to be substituted positive here because negative sign is taken care while solving this. So VCE value will will be equal to VCEQ1 and VCEQ2. So this is the way we find the Q point, substituting the values in the formula. And next, what we want to find is, next we want to find with respect to numerical number 1, AD, ACM and CMRR. So RPI is given by the formula beta VT upon ICQ, where VT is 26 millivolt, ICQ value we just now found. So RPI came out to be this number, that is 2.654 kilo ohms. Now the formula of AD for a DIUO configuration is beta RC upon twice RPI plus RS. So we have to substitute the value. Here we have RS terminology, which RS is given as 100 ohms. So AD value will come out to be a number which is around 90.77. You can work it out with the calculators. ACM value will always remain the same, that is RC upon twice RE for all the configurations. So that always, one more thing you remember is ACM value will come always less than 1. So you keep a note of it. ACM value has to be always less than 1. CMRR will be AD upon ACM. So you divide them and you get a bigger number. And you take the 20 log of that, you will get CMRR in dB. So that's how you solved a numerical on a BJT differential amplifier. Now let's go ahead and check another numerical of similar kind. So yeah, so here you have another BJT differential amplifier. Now this BJT differential amplifier is a DIBO differential amplifier configuration, since we have both the inputs and we have two outputs which are here taken across. The output voltage is measured across the collector terminals. So here we have the absence of RS or RB register over here. So how we will modify this, we'll see. The beta values and VB values are given. If VB value is not given, you have to assume it to be 0.7. And this is a symmetric network. So let us see how do we solve this sum. The DC analysis will remain the same. So first you will get the value of IBQ. IBQ value will always come in microamperes. Keep a note of it. And your RS is missing, so RS has substituted as 0 over here. And ICQ value will be beta times IBQ. So IC1 will be equal to IC2 will be equal to 1.695. Similarly, VCQ, you found out, you work out with the substitute the values in this formulas. So you will get VC1 equal to VCQ2 equal to 10.779 in this case. So that's how you calculate the Q point. Next, we calculate the values for, let me just little bit expand this thing so that you all can see it clearly. Yeah, so we need to find differential voltage gain, common mode voltage gain, and CMRR for numerical 2. So we calculate the value of RPI first. So RPI will be beta VT upon ICQ. So you'll get a number by solving it in calculator. Then you find out AD value. Remember, this is a DIBO configuration. So AD formula will be beta RC upon RS plus RPI. So you work it out, you will get a number, that is 78.22. ACM will be RC upon twice RE. I've already told you ACM value always comes less than 1. So you get a number over here, that is 0.182. Then you divide AD by ACM, you will get CMRR. And then you take 20 log of that, you will get the CMRR in dB. And now let us go ahead and look into another numerical. Now this another numerical is basically based on the swamping resistors. So the DC formula and the AC formula will change accordingly. So as for the DC formula, you have ICQ worked out by using this formula. Your RE dash is same as your RE swamp resistor. So do include this term and you will work out with the value, that is ICQ will come out to be 1.158 milliamperes. Directly we have calculated ICQ over here. So now again VCQ, this RE dash swamp resistor has to be accounted for. And let me just keep the screen over here. Yeah. So this is the numerical. I hope you all can see this numerical on your screens. Yeah, so this is the numerical. So now AC analysis can be worked out like this. In the differential gain formula, you have this beta RE swamp formula. Since it is a DIBO configuration, I think, I suppose there is some mistake here. Yeah, there is a mistake over here. This is a DIBO form, DIBO configuration. So your two sign will not come. So basically it will be not be divided by two. So this two sign, you have to ignore it. While solving it, please take care of the formula. It will be beta RZ upon RS plus R pi plus beta RE dash. So this two sign will not be there for a DIBO configuration. So your the value worked out around here is a little bit wrong. And you can work it out correctly. So ACM value, you substitute in RC upon twice RE formula. So it will come around 0.6. So CMRR value will not be this because there is a mistake over here. CMRR will be some different value. So here you will get it CMRR equal to 20 log of that AD upon ACM. And you will get a new value since this AD value is wrong. So kindly take care of such numericals. So we have completed with BJT differential amplifier topic. So next time we'll see MOSFET differential amplifier numerical. Thank you.